Yesterday, at 10:08 a.m. local time on April 14, 2025, the ground began to move in Southern California, but due to the correct usage of the state's early warning system, many people were alerted seconds before it began. As back and forth shaking occurred, items rustled around and water sloshed in pools, lasting for approximately 10 seconds. This earthquake registered in as a moderate magnitude 5.2, and despite an early incorrect assertion it was a larger magnitude 6 event, it did not seemingly cause any notable damage. This earthquake was felt across portions of three U.S. states, including Los Angeles, Hollywood, San Diego, and Palm Springs in California, Las Vegas in Nevada, and Yuma and Lake Havasu City in Arizona. Several reports were submitted to the USGS website for the aforementioned earthquake, claiming that scattered people felt the quake in Durango, Colorado, Las Cruces, New Mexico, El Paso, Texas, Roosevelt, Utah, and Phoenix, Arizona, but I am skeptical of these reports, especially since I live in Phoenix and felt nothing. So, why did this earthquake occur, and why are some scientists mentioning the name of the San Andreas Fault? After all, this is the full extent of the San Andreas Fault, with its closest extent being 50 miles to the northeast. This quake did not occur on the San Andreas Fault, but rather on the Elsinore Fault. To prevent confusion, I want to note the difference between three similar terms that mean different scientific things which are being used: fault, fault zone, and fault system. A fault represents a fracture or series of fractures between two blocks of rock that allows it to move to accommodate regional stresses. A fault zone represents an area where frequent earthquakes generally occur that includes multiple smaller faults which are closely spaced. And a fault system represents a grouping of multiple faults and/or fault zones that accommodates regional tectonic stresses. Thus, while the earthquake occurred on the Elsinore Fault, it was part of the larger Elsinore Fault Zone, which itself is part of the even larger San Andreas Fault System, since it accommodates a portion of the motion between the North American and Pacific tectonic plates. Hopefully this clarifies the terms being thrown around. But what about the earthquake? Why did this occur? Well, the Elsinore Fault is a right lateral strike slip fault, and if we overlay the moment tensor for the quake which struck, we can see that the noted motion is exactly what would be expected on that fault. This fault moves approximately 4 millimeters or 0.16 inches a year, and this stress built up and was partially released in a segment which I estimate to be 4 kilometers or 2.49 miles long, resulting in a maximum of 8 inches or 20 centimeters of ground movement. In historic times, across the length of the Elsinore Fault Zone which goes into Mexico, a total of 16 earthquakes of magnitude 5 or larger have struck, including a magnitude 6.0 in 1769, a magnitude 7.2 in 2010, and a magnitude 7.3 in 1892. Research indicates that this fault zone is capable of producing earthquakes of up to magnitude 7.5, so is there any reason to worry about one soon occurring? The answer to this is no, not really, although there technically is a very small chance. Any time a large earthquake strikes, the risk of a larger earthquake happening temporarily increases, albeit very slightly for a time. By 10:58 a.m. on April 21st, the U.S. Geological Survey has used statistical averages and modeling to suggest the chance of at least one of the following magnitude aftershocks or greater occurring: for a magnitude 3 or larger, 88% chance; for a magnitude 4 or larger, 39% chance; for a magnitude 5 or larger, 7% chance; for a magnitude 6 or larger, 1% chance; and for a magnitude 7 or larger, 0.1% chance. In other words, in all likelihood, the magnitude 5.2 quake which struck does not represent the foreshock to an even larger damaging earthquake. Besides, the largest average aftershock after an earthquake strikes is 1.2 magnitudes lower than the main quake. As a quick edit, before this video goes live, already 129 aftershocks have struck, the largest of which happened to be exactly a magnitude 4.0. And yes, 13 smaller foreshocks occurred in the 19 hours preceding the April 14th magnitude 5.2 quake. The rate of aftershocks is expected to progressively decrease at a rate of 1 over x, with x representing time over the following days to weeks. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member Annie Umfrey for supporting my work.